using flowers to signify Lisa, Quentin, Stacy, and Elijah. As each flower is passed on to William and Jacki, they become a bouquet, more than just a number of balloons. Just as in this union, they will become a family greater than the sum of their parts. Friends and family, we have been invited here today to share with William and Jacki a very important moment in their lives. We join them not to mark the beginning of a relationship, but to recognize a bond between them that already exists. This ceremony is a public affirmation to the family and friends gathered here today, as well as to the memories of those not present that are held in their hearts. When you love someone, you do not love them all the time in exactly the same way from moment to moment. It is impossible, and a lie to pretend to. And yet this is what most of us want from another person. We have so little faith in the ebb and flow of life, love, and relationships. We jump at the flow when the tide comes in, and are afraid as it pulls away. We are afraid it will never return. We insist on permanency, on duration, on continuity. When the only real continuity in life and love is in growth, in fluidity, in freedom. The only real security is in not owning or possessing, nor in demanding or expecting, not even in hoping. Security in a relationship doesn't come from looking back to how it was in nostalgia, or looking forward to what might happen with dread or anticipation. but in living in the present relationship and accepting it as it is now. Love is like a temporary madness. It erupts like a volcano and then subsides. It is not the breathlessness, the excitement, or the swearing it will never end. That is only being in love, which anyone can do. Real love is what's left over when being in love has burned away. And this is as much of an art as it is an accident. Those who truly love have roots that grow toward each other under the surface. And although the blossoms may fall from the branches, they find that they have become one tree, not two. And from talking to Jacki and William, this is what they have realized in each other, and what we have come today to recognize and celebrate.
Jacki, you know, the first time I saw you at IU, the football game, climbing up the hill, kept falling down two or three times. And I knew then, if I ever would meet you, that I would love you. And all the time that we've been apart, there's not been a day that I have not loved you. I love you more today, and I know that God has blessed me that when I leave this earth, I will be. I will be a happy man because He's brought you back in my life. Thank you.
First time I ever looked in your eyes, I saw how much you loved me, and I loved you completely. My heart and my soul. And even when we were apart, we were always connected. We always were connected with our hearts and with our soul. And I am blessed to be loved by you. And I'm blessed by God that I've been given this chance to love you completely for the rest of my life.
The world does a good job of reminding us how fragile we are. Individuals are fragile as well as relationships. Every marriage needs the love, nurture, and support of family and friends. Let those gathered here today be friends not only to each William and Jacki, but to the relationship as well. By the power vested in me by the State of Indiana and the Universal Life Church, I now pronounce you Mr. and Mrs. Fikes. You may now kiss. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be sheltered to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth for the other. Now there is no more loneliness, for though you are two persons, there is only one life before you. May your days together be good and long upon the earth. May I present to all of you the newly married couple, William and Jacki. Dance in the bubbles.
Yeah, dance in the bubbles.
We can stop that one. Different. It floated around in a glass.